Yeah, my name is Timur Ahmadiev. I am from Moscow, Russia, and I'm here in Slovenia for the first time. And I'd like to thank organizers for letting me speak here. And I'm really looking forward to this conference. I work for Bithem, and Bithem is a Canadian company that has more than 400 people worldwide helping customers to get the most out of their disruptive technologies. Okay. I am a DBA for the last 4 years, and before that I've been a developer, actually, a long, long time ago, and I'm actually been a Java developer sometime long time ago. That is a short version of about me slide, and there is a slightly longer version about it, but I'm just gonna skip it because I knew. So, at the moment I'm a database consultant. I'm interested in systems architecture and performance mostly, and I'm tweeting sometimes. Yeah, Twitter is great, by the way. So what I'm going to talk about today is about complex applications, whatever that means. I'm going to talk about slightly what usually happens when a performance issue is observed in application, some kind of applications. And I'm going to be speaking regularly about what capacity and what performance mean. Okay? And I'm going to try and shortly describe what should probably happen when a performance issue happens in an application, okay? So let's start. Today, probably all applications are complex by design. I'm gonna talk about applications that are deployed in this architecture. They usually multiple tiers. One tier is a load balancer, either hardware or software. And there is an application clusters, which is running in something like Java, C#, whatever. I'm specifically be speaking about applications that are mostly written in Java, because I'm dealing most of the time with them. But what I'm gonna be speaking is actually language independent, okay? And it's actually mostly database independent as well. Okay, so it can be applied to any kind of technology. So the application connects to the database and does some queries and runs some queries, some procedures, something like that. It also is communicating to the external systems. And those external systems might be as well be deployed in the same way in three tiers, right? And so why this is a complex architecture, I think, it's because it's supported by different people. That's, I think, the biggest problem with them. You have database people dealing with the database. You have application developers dealing with the application. You have some storage administrator, some network administrators, and maybe even people who are calling themselves network operation center. So to make this thing work as a whole is a big challenge. And just communicating between different teams make this application architecture complex by design. So what happens when the application performance issue happens in any kind of application, complex, not complex? So this is kind of response that I hear probably most of the time. Okay, so somebody like from database team or application team says that the load is on the database or application is low, so it must be good, so there should be no issues with the performance. And unfortunately this is the worst kind of reply you can hear. And what is worse about it, it's not like the person doesn't understand what performance is. The problem is that the management who hears that kind of response, they start thinking that this is what should be done when we hear, when we see performance issue. When something happens, this is what usually happens. somebody is checking the load or something like that on the database, on the application, and yeah, things go further. Another kind of response from the people who are obsessed or who are not seeing good performance from the I/O, they are obsessed with I/O per second, okay? It's a kind of metric which is great and for some time, okay? Yeah, this is kind of response I hear as well. And whenever performance issue happens, people tend to check I/O performance and they are looking at the at this probably. And ultimately, when nothing happens and nothing could be done, well, everything is good, the application is being restarted, okay? And who does that? Nobody. Nobody. Okay, you're doing good. Yeah, actually, I think any environment that I've seen, any, at some point, they start doing it, and it happens regularly. That's the kind of worrying thing. And some vendors, Oracle included, they actually like recommending it. They recommend restarts like once a week, sometimes once a day. At the previous conference, I was told that somebody restarted their application every day, okay, because of some performance issues with the application. Right, so restarts, they happen, and what's even worse is that they help. Okay, so, and because they help, like, yeah, it's like index of bills. Yeah, people keep doing it. But that's not even the worst part. The worst part is that consequence that the performance issues are there, restart help, and some people say we don't have enough capacity, so we actually need to add some capacity, some application nodes into the cluster to make application runs better, okay? And this is kind of response which is also common, and which is based on assumption that there is no enough capacity in the application, and if we add that capacity, things will go better. And what's even worse is that sometimes things are indeed getting slightly better, which I also don't like. So what's wrong about that? The short answer is that people are looking at the wrong data. It's probably high. The shortest, if I need to make my presentation in like one slide, it's about this. People are looking at the wrong data, making conclusions about things based on the wrong data. In particular, they are looking at some metrics on some graphs, okay? So here I have some metric, and people are looking at these numbers, like metric is this, metric is that, okay? Well, the problem is that the performance is a different dimension, okay? Performance, it's not about this metric, which is CPU or number of I/O per second. It's about how many seconds have passed from the start of the request to the end of the request. Okay, it sounds so simple, it really is, but unfortunately, for many, many people, some metric is actually have more meaning than the response time, okay? And this is kind of slide that I want to show to everyone, and I want you, if there is one thing that you need to remember from my presentation, and please remember this, okay? Right, so why is that? Because for many, many metrics, it doesn't really matter what is the value of the metric, whether it's low or high. The performance of the application might be either good or bad with any kind of metric. You can get good performance with a high metric value. You can have a bad performance when the metric is low. And it is relevant for any kind of